Good morning, internet. It is 7:45 in the morning and welcome back to the channel. I am now back in the Netherlands, in Utrecht, for some time now. And today I'm going to give you an update on what's going on with Dano, what is going on with Ronin, and who this mystery bike is. So, do you know what it is? This is the Honda CB500F. So it's pretty much kind of like a sister of Ronin. Same engine, just slightly different. It's even lower than Ronin. So yeah, a little bit more sporty feel. And this is my ride for this morning. Now this is probably a little bit confusing, so let me kind of give you a quick update on what's going on before I set off. So first Dano, what's happening with Dano? Dano is still in Peru, but she's coming back. I've obviously been looking on the news, what's going on in the world, and there is just no way I can go back to Peru and continue my journey to Alaska anytime soon. I was really hoping I could, but countries are still closed, borders are closed. And Dano is of course on a temporary import permit in Peru, and I extended it with 6 months. And that is running out. Now I could try to extend it again, but to be honest, I mean, she is just parked there in a garage, kind of like rusting away, is an expression. Dano just needs to get out of there. There's still a lot of my personal stuff there as well. So I decided that Dano has to get out of Peru and has to come back to the Netherlands. I cannot just send her to any other country because of temporary import permits. She is on a Dutch license plate, so that means that I cannot send her, for example, to Alaska or something without myself being there and doing all that paperwork and having no idea if I can go there. And yeah, the only real option to getting her out of Peru is getting her back to the Netherlands. And I've been working on this for weeks now, and it is not easy. It's just really hard, actually. For now, the update I can give is that they drained the petrol out of the tank and they're building a crate. And that's been going on for a little while now. And then she's gonna be put on a boat and come back to the Netherlands. So this boat will, I don't know, take another 6 weeks, maybe 2 months. So it's going to be a while before Dano is back. So yeah, in the meantime, I've of course been riding Ronin, and I love the bike, honestly. I think it's an amazing bike. I'm having so much fun, and especially on road, of course, Ronin is performing a lot better than Basanti and Dano ever did. There's just not really any denying about it. And off-road, Ronin did actually pretty well. I was pretty amazed with how that went. But that could be a little bit better. I felt like I was holding back a little bit, or I was driving extra carefully, and I just want to be able to like blast over like dirt tracks or gravel roads or whatever. So what I decided to do is that I will continue riding with Ronin for a lot more, but I will upgrade Ronin so that Ronin will perform excellent both on road and off road. So that's the plan. And this upgrade will consist of new wheels and new suspension. And that will mean that Ronin is going to be probably 5 centimeters taller than she is now, which is quite a lot. Let me in the meantime get the lock off because I'm doing too much talking. Anyway, so I think it's really important if you have a tall bike that you don't have too much weight on the bike, because the more weight, the more likely you're going to the more likely it is to drop the bike, especially if you're riding on unpaved terrain. That will mean that I'm going to stop camping. I already posted something on Instagram quite a while ago that the whole camping experience in the northern of Europe, it just didn't work for me with keeping up with the channel. It was just insane, and I was like, if I want to bring out 3 videos per week, the whole camping is, it's just not possible. And well, I have a couple of other reasons which I explained there, but especially if I want to ride a lighter bike, it is so much gear that you have to bring with you that I will not bring it with me. So that will be like 10 kilograms less or something like that. That will make a massive difference. And another thing that will make a difference is change the exhaust on Ronin. And that's what's going to be happening today. So back to the exhaust. gave myself an early Christmas present. And I bought myself a Akrapovic exhaust. So with that Akrapovic exhaust, I saved 2 kilograms of weight. The stock exhaust is double the weight. And I have amazing sound, because let's be honest, Ronin with the stock exhaust kind of sounds like a vacuum cleaner. And well, yeah, I just miss the sound of the bike. So today they're going to install that exhaust on Ronin, and they're also going to install some heated grips. Finally, I decided to go for heated grips. I will be riding winter in Europe, and yeah, I think it's time for a little bit more comfort. Huh? I'm getting older as well, you know. But anyway, the reason why I am now riding on this little baby is that Ronin also needs a big service, because she passed 24,000 kilometers. So yeah, I already did 15,000 on Ronin since I got her. And at 24,000 they need to do a valve check, valve clearance check. And for that the engine needs to be cold. So I dropped Ronin last night at Goedhart Motoren, that's where I'm going now. They are about 20 minutes from Utrecht. So I dropped her yesterday, and then they gave me this bike to ride to Utrecht. And now I'm gonna go there. I asked them if I could film a little bit to show you the installation of the exhaust and the heated grips. And they said, okay. So we're gonna do that today. It's a beautiful morning. I don't really have time to explore back roads or anything, so it's just going to be highway. But yeah, this CB500F, it is so low, I cannot believe it. Like, it is even lower than Ronin. For the rest, it rides pretty similar, to be honest. I mean, yeah, engine is the same. I have obviously a little bit more a forward position. It's kind of nice, actually. For just fun rides. But yeah, other than that, not much different. Oh, this is a nice place. Hearts. It's a super big bike shop. I think it's one of the biggest in the area, to be honest. It's huge. That was a fun ride. Now you have to check out this shop. Look how huge. This is it, Akrapovic. Oh, exciting, exciting. This is it. I'm going to unbox it now. Don't drop the free exhaust. Oh. So what do you guys think? Looks so much better, so I cannot wait to hear the sound, but I'll have to be a little bit more patient for that. Now it just needs to be attached here. But yeah, 2 kilograms less than the stock exhaust. And I already noticed a little bit of rust actually on the exhaust. Where did I see it? See, this is heavy. See there? Which I think shouldn't be there, but okay. Right, so now it's time for the heated grips, and I got this, these are from Daytona. They recommended them here in the shop because you get those Oxford ones. I think they are the most common ones, but they have quite a big control unit. And this control unit is a little bit smaller, so I thought it was maybe a bit better. So that's why I chose these ones. So let's see, we're gonna put them on now. So I will not have cold hands anymore. I'm really looking forward to that. Especially when I start riding, because now I'm obviously riding or going to ride in European winter, so that's going to be a little bit cold. Let's see. Ronin is looking a little bit naked at the moment. Because if you have to do valve clearance on this bike, you have to take off everything. So yeah, it's actually quite a lot of work to do that. So luckily it only has to be done every 24,000 kilometers, I think. So that's good. Because yeah, you don't want to do this every 10 or something. Ready for a test ride. So the you hear that? They're doing some dyno testing. Check. Can't see it. Anyway, surface is done, everything's done, so now a mechanic is taking Ronin for a test ride, and then I'm good to go if everything's okay, but I think so. Ja, ik deed net al even, maar je kan net niks zien vanaf hier. So, ready to go, Ronin is ready. Let's check the new exhaust.
Oh, it's sounding great. So this is the button for my heated grips, so no more cold hands. So, Rodin feels as new, 24,000 kilometer service done. So, yeah, I'm going to ride back to Utrecht. So that was it for today. I really hope you liked this video. If you did, please give me a big thumbs up and subscribe down below. And then I will see you in the next video. Ha 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 ha.